4 films in 2 in Kannada, 1 in Telugu, 1 in Tamil and 1 Hindi, all of them flopped. Acting is not considered to be a respectable job, and when you're an actress, they think, oh, you're public property. I want to work with Ajith sir. Chennai romba pidichirukku.
Romba pidichirukku.
Thank you. The last interview that Vishakha Singh gave before retiring from Tamil cinema was courtesy.
நம்ம பட்டணத்துக்கு விசாகா வராங்க தெரியல, அப்போது நம்ம பட்டணம் விசாகா பட்டணம். இப்படி ஒரு கடி ஜோக்கில் ஒரு இன்டர்வியூ ஆரம்பிக்கிறது தேவையா அப்படின்னு கேட்குறது புரியுது. கொஞ்சம் இருங்க, நான் வந்து விசாகா பற்றி சொல்கிறேன். ஒரு தரகர் வராரு, பொண்ணு எப்படி இருப்பாள், பொண்ணு பார்க்க அழகாக இருப்பாள், நல்ல கலை, நல்ல சம்பளம், நிறைய பணம் இருக்குது, சொத்து இருக்குது, எல்லாம் சொன்னாங்க. என்ன நட்சத்திரம், விசாகா நட்சத்திரம், இங்கே விசாகாவே தான் நட்சத்திரம். இது உங்களுக்கு புரியலன்னா, விசாகாக்கு என்ன சென்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஹியூமர் அப்படின்னு கேட்டிங்கன்னா, நம்ம இப்போ சோமர்செட்டில் தான் இந்த இன்டர்வியூ பண்ணுறோம்ல. நேற்று வந்து நீங்கள் சோமர்செட் வந்துருங்க, இட்ஸ் லொக்கேட்டட் நியர் சாந்தோம் ஆரியபுரம் அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு, இன்கேஸ் திஸ் இஸ் க்ரீக் அண்ட் லாட்டின் ஐ வில் கைட் யூ இன்னொன்னு, டோன்ட் வரி ஐ ஆம் இன் ரோம், க்ரீக் அண்ட் லாட்டின் இஸ் க்ளோஸ் டு மீன்னாங்க. நான் சொன்னேன் ரோம் க்ளோஸ் ஓகே, பட் யூ ஷுட் பி ரோமிங். அதுக்காக தான் இந்த இடத்த சொன்னேன், இப்படி தான் ஆரம்பிச்சுது. இப்போ நேராக ஃபஸ்ட் டைம் மீட் பண்ணுறேன். வணக்கம் விசாகா.
வணக்கம்.
ஸோ விசாகா, நம்ம தமிழில் ஆரம்பிக்கிறோம், அப்புறம் கொஞ்சம் கொஞ்சமாக உங்களோட இங்கிலீஷ்லேயே நான் வரேன். சென்னை எப்படி இருக்கு, பிடிச்சிருக்கா? சென்னை பிடிச்சிருக்கு.
சென்னை ரொம்ப பிடிச்சிருக்கு.
ரொம்ப பிடிச்சிருக்கு. யுவர் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஃபிலிம் வாஸ் பிடிச்சிருக்கு.
எஸ் எஸ்.
சோ தி ஃபர்ஸ்ட் திங், நவ கமிங் டு தட் பிரேக், ஐ ரெட் ஒன் வெரி இன்ட்ரஸ்டிங் இன்டர்வியூ ஆஃப் யுவர்ஸ் இன் தி நியூஸ் பேப்பர் டுடே, விச் சேஸ் தட் நார்மலி ஆக்டர்ஸ் டு அ ஃபுல் ஃப்ளெஜ் ரோல் ஃபார் 60 டு 70 டேஸ் அண்ட் டேக் அ பிரேக் கோயிங் டு யூரோப் அந்தமான்ஸ் தென் சிங் ஜூபிட்டர் ப்ளூட்டோ ஆல் தட், பட் விசாகா இஸ் டோட்லி டிஃப்ரெண்ட், வேர் ஷி கீப்ஸ் டூயிங் அர் ஓன் பிஸ்னஸ், மைண்ட்ஸ் அர் ஓன் பிஸ்னஸ், சடன்லி வென் இட் கம்ஸ் டு பிரேக் ஷி லேண்ட்ஸ் அப் இன் அ ஸ்டுடியோ அண்ட் ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் ஆக்டிங். So your profession seems to be your break. What is that? It's totally confusing.
No, I don't know. I'm just one of those defective pieces who does things against the tide.
I thought you're detective. You're defective, is it?
I'm defective. I'll tell you why I'm a defective piece.
That's because you're with me now.
No, I'll tell you. My mom was 4 months pregnant when she found out she was pregnant. She had no idea. This thing.
Who informed her?
Well, I apparently started kicking inside. And then she was like, oops, am I pregnant?
And she got a kick out of that.
Totally.
Good one.
Totally, yes.
Superb. Lovely start. So what is that? It's a profession or a break? You are acting, you are foray into films. Is this a profession? Is your duty or is it a break?
I don't know. I'm trying to figure out. I think I'm just one of those people who are born with a little bit of acting talent. I haven't harnessed
it
yet.
Has anybody else told you this other than yourself?
No, it's a fact. It's day outside, it's a fact. Right? So I have a little bit of talent. I know that.
It's a fact. Latent.
Yeah. And I'm saying it with all humility. Okay. But,
good.
But, I was very interested
in
acting.
You act well now.
Okay. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So, 2008 to 2010, when I was very young, I was interested in acting full time. But you know, when you're young, you're trying to figure out in life what you really want to do. So, over a period of 4 films, in 2 in Kannada, 1 in Telugu, 1 in Tamil and 1 Hindi, all of them flopped. I realized, okay, I like acting, but I'm not getting to act in the kind of films I want to act in. And this process is too hard. I don't think I want to do this. So, I left it. 2011 onwards, I started working with my dad.
Okay.
And then suddenly...
And dad for each other.
Absolutely dad for each other, completely, all the time. And then 2013 onwards, I suddenly just started getting films again. So my dad was like, okay, just finish up with that and come back. So I came, I did Kanna Laddu and I did 3 Hindi films. One of them was a Fukre, which was a huge hit again.
Oh, right.
Yeah, did that, then went back again, came back again. So it's my, I don't know.
So you're totally confused now and you're not in a position to
now
design.
That I'm older and wiser, I have realized that...
So that's an antonym. You can never call yourself older, seriously.
No, but why? Old is not a bad word.
Old is gold.
Old is gold.
Absolutely.
Imagine I'm older, I'm wiser, and I still look pretty.
Wow.
Isn't that
pretty
nice?
Good.
Yeah, it's pretty good. It's pretty good, isn't it? And I feel I have the sensibilities now to select films as per my own choice. I mean, usually actresses don't get
to choose. But the language is not of your choice. That's the problem.
No, but that's not a problem. You know, why should acting...
You know, for the listener, for the watcher.
No. I mug up my lines, no, and I say the lines
and
in their language.
And you don't dub it.
Not yet, unless the direction team is willing to work hard with me.
I'm willing to bear with your accent.
Yes.
So how did you pick up Tamil? Is it because of the dialogue writer or you're getting to meet a lot of people here?
No. What happens is, you know, when I'm doing my lines, I do my scenes. I mean, after pack up, I take up the scenes for the next day. And I go back to the room and 2 hours I'm mugging up my lines. Oh. Then next day in the morning, 5 a.m. I get up, I again mug up my lines. You know, so that's
really?
My learning process.
You never did this even in school or college, I guess.
I swear. I mean, that's like an exam every day. every
day. Now that you say that, it is more of a pastime here because I'm not able to stick to it as a profession.
Right.
But if you are getting into the skin of the character, there's some very different character which you
right,
have to do.
Right.
I don't think you can treat it as a hobby. It has to necessarily...
True. See, I am passionate about acting, but as I said, my sensibilities have to gel in with the kind of work I'm doing. And let's be honest about it. Women don't get a lot many great roles. You're either the hero's love interest or you're his mother. You're defined by the hero.
That's,
you know,
right.
I'm not saying,
and
you
there aren't many roles that glorify women.
Exactly, and not every film should be like that, because it's, at the end of the day, it's a film. Film is a business, you know. And if the major audience is men, you have to cater to their needs. But when the woman in the film, I mean, you need to give her something more. Like when directors here approach me, they say, "Madam, this is the girl, and she's so and so. She's waiting to get married." I'm like, "Is that all she's doing? She has to do something more. You know, what does she think? Tell me that."
At least love.
That anyway, she has to love, she has to look pretty, you know. So usually even when you review, they're like, the heroine was looking pretty.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm like, array, what is that review?
You can't treat the heroine as a set property, just standing there, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
She has to do something extra. But
something.
But fortunately, in that Iridhi Chuttu, there was a person, no, Ritika Singh.
Oh, she is
She did
phenomenal.
A lovely role, she was given
phenomenal.
A lovely role.
Phenomenal, phenomenal.
She had some good essence
absolutely,
to the character.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So you choose your character like that, or you're okay with a good story? You're not bothered about what's your role in it?
Both. It has to be, it has to be a producer who can release the film. It has to be a director who can direct you well. It has to be a good story that you feel proud to be a part of, and definitely a good role. You need at least 4 or 5 tick marks, and it has to be good money. Good
coming
money.
To,
yeah.
Coming to Kanna Laddu Nayasaya, it was complete comedy, you know?
Yeah, totally.
Complete comedy. It's difficult because even in Tamil, there are a lot of various types of Tamil, like Madras, Tirunelveli Tamil, Coimbatore Tamil, and all that. And it must have been a real challenge for you.
You know, coming to the different kinds of Tamil, I did Oor Urula Rendu Raja for Priya. I did a special appearance in her film, where I'm her friend.
They assured me it was a comedy film. I became so serious in that film. Only time I was laughing was during the interval, 5 minutes.
Seriously? No, that's the film.
I appreciate the director because he was so confident and he told me, "Boss, this is comedy. Be careful." He warned me.
I think what happens is, I don't want to judge anybody, but I'm just saying it was a nice film. But the marketing peg that is given, there's no connect. I think that's why the marketing team needs to be part of the creative team.
Okay,
let's get away from that.
Not a very exciting topic, I know that. But I was surprised your foray into Hindi films didn't click that much.
Mm. It did. See,
no, to start with, as a child artist.
Not as a child artist. I played a freedom fighter in this film called Khele Hamji Jaanse in 2010.
The audience also fought for freedom. They don't.
Yeah, well. Well, so but
what was your role like in Swadesh?
No, not Swadesh. Swadesh was the
Swadesh
film.
Swadesh, where you rejected?
No, Swadesh, I was shortlisted.
Okay.
I was among the top 3 girls who were shortlisted and kept on hold for 4 months.
Oh.
And then Ashu sir said that I was in school then. So he said, "You look too young next to Shah Rukh," you know.
Oh, really?
And my only thing that has kept me going all these years is that if an Oscar nominee director like Ashutosh Gowarikar has seen something in me, I have something.
Great. That's,
you know,
right.
So that's what kept me going. And
so what are the plus points that really attracted Ashutosh towards
I don't know.
Him?
I'm assuming, he says I have a lot of intensity. I'm assuming there's a lot of sincerity.
You must have gone places in Bollywood then.
No, but then it depends on where, you know what?
Because half the time you're sitting in Europe, I think that's the problem.
No, I think it's what I want. I don't want to be the number one.
Yeah, that's the break you want. You want a break here.
Yeah, exactly. Do a little bit of work, be happy in that work.
Okay. Well, what are the roles you're anticipating that you will get? Some very different role. Yeah, here it's very easy. They'll tell you opening one ghost. gang. No opening
yeah,
scene.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's a ghost or a boxing film. That's must know. That's the season.
I'll learn boxing then. Excuse me, any director watching?
No,
I know
we are planning. Actually, our team is planning one new film.
Yeah.
A ghost is boxing.
Awesome.
It's a combination of both. So we get.
So I've done a ghost film and I'll learn boxing now.
You're going to do a ghost film now?
Yeah, a film called Bayamuru Payanam.
Bayamuru Payanam.
Yes.
So what are you? Are you the producer or?
I'm just the actor.
Just the actor. What sort of a role is it? Will we get to watch your face in that, or
you
going to be invisible role?
No. I will be seen. You'll see a very scary side of me.
As it is, you're such.
No, I'll scare you more, Bosskey. More, lots more.
What about
probably give you nightmares.
What about the prosthetics in that?
Oh, the prosthetics was a lot of fun. You know, it was like blood trickling down, blood in the eye, and the cuts and all that.
Okay.
So it was good. You know, it was very refreshing to not worry about looking beautiful.
Oh,
because I was sleeping 2.5 hours every night, and I didn't have to worry about dark circles because I had to look like a ghost. I said, great.
Oh, great. And how are you going to, how do you foresee competition here? Almost every week there's a new hero, heroine who's cropping up now. And you will have to really equip yourself very uniquely to muster this competition. So how is it going to happen?
I'm in competition with nobody. Oh, I'm happy with myself. Really? I'm happy with my life. Because the moment you start thinking, oh my God, I need to go ahead, I don't want to go through that agonizing this thing. I've done that from 2008 to 2010.
Oh, right.
I don't wish to repeat that. I'm very happy in my space. So I wish everybody does well.
But do you foresee your re-entry into Hindi films?
I am doing 3 Hindi films this year.
Right.
See,
now.
Imagine, like, the beauty of it all is that people work, they do films. Why? Because they want to get more films, because they want to get more fame, they want to get more money. By the grace of God, I have a little bit of fame, and money-wise, I'm smart enough to make money outside. Why would I want to do a film unless it's really fantastic and gives me creative satisfaction? You know, so
give me the feeling that I'm somewhere down the Himalayas because
See, older and wiser. See, I told you this is what the film industry has done to me. See, all those struggles from 2008 to 2010 have made me.
But who really gave you the feeling that you're going to become an actor? Did you impress somebody? Somebody spotted your talent.
Ashutosh Gavarikar. Because when I was holidaying and then his assistant spotted me, I went and auditioned.
Where did they spot you?
Mumbai, Bandra, Linking Road.
Linking Road. What were you doing there?
I was shopping.
You were linking. They linked you to films in Linking Road.
Exactly.
How did that happen?
Well, I was shopping and this assistant came saying, you want to act in films? And there I was
we
in
have
school.
A shopping scene. You shop so well. Please come.
Please come,
You
yes.
went and shopped in the industry.
So anyway, I went and auditioned because I was like, oh, Ashutosh Gavarikar, and my parents were like, acha, okay, Lagan director, all right, fine, you know. Okay. Audition, but I didn't get it, so.
Okay.
But then, as I said.
Did they give you a reason for that?
No, Ashutosh said. He said, you look too young.
That's the only reason.
That was the only reason, so which is fair enough. Or maybe I was a bad actor, I don't know. But I didn't get selected, I was in the top 3.
Oh, great. And who are the heroes who have caught your eye here and you are vying to act with, probably, if you get a chance? By any chance, you are part of 2.0, that Rajini's next film? Why that smile? Right. It's a matter of pride, isn't it?
No, of course it's a matter of pride.
Okay. For Rajini.
Oh my God.
I think your future is assured here in this interview, I think.
Totally. Thank you. The last interview that Vishakha Singh gave before retiring from Tamil cinema was courtesy.
Courtesy, okay. Your presence with Rajini, presence with Kamal, Surya, Vikram and all that. So how do you
I want to work with Ajith, sir.
With Ajith?
Yes.
So most of them, I mean 9 out of 10 females say the same thing.
Mm.
So what is so special about him? The screen
I don't
presence?
Know, I would want to work with him to find out.
What are the films that fascinated you of his?
Well, it's not more than the films, it's his attitude. I met him once when I was shooting for my Telugu film.
You think you're too young to be a heroine?
No, now I'm old enough to be his heroine.
And what did he say?
No, he, you know, I was walking and my assistant Basha was with me and Basha went, looking
Basha,
at
Basha, Rajini.
Basha, my assistant. Okay.
Yeah. Oh, Basha, Rajini is your assistant. Okay, yeah, makeup man. Your assistant.
You are so going to have it from all Rajini sir's fans, you know that? You are so.
I am myself a great, huge fan of Rajini, it's not a problem.
Okay.
Well, so, you're back to this.
Yeah, so anyway, so.
You were walking.
6:30 in the morning, I'm going for my shoot, looking all like sleepy and going, and suddenly I see this man coming in a red t-shirt and this thing. And I look up, and what a gentleman, he says, good morning. And I was like, good morning. And then I was like, and Basha is like, you know, and then he said,
and
I was like,
also
I was like, so he's been talking about you for days. And he was like, really? I said, then my assistant wanted
Thala
a picture
popularly
with
known
him.
As Thala.
Yeah, so I was clicking my assistant's picture with Ajith sir. And I was like, I'm sorry we're bothering you at 6 a.m. And he was like, no, I would be worried if you guys didn't click a picture with me. And that is the mark of a true actor. Wow. To be humble
super.
And to be, you know, so polite. And I was like, wow, I was so floored. I said, I have to work with him.
So you were walking in the normal passage. What about walking on the ramp?
I don't know, I'm not tall enough.
Ramp walk, size
I'm
0,
not,
you know.
No, I eat food, I love eating food.
You love eating?
I love
veg, non-veg?
I'm a vegetarian now.
Why isn't that you're into the not into the ramp?
Because I'm not tall enough.
Oh really? Yeah. I thought you were quite tall.
No, I'm just about 5'4".
5'4", and your heels is 5?
No, heels is 6 inches.
Your dressing sense and all that, more of North Indian-ish or you look more South Indian.
Yeah,
I have to admit that.
Well, I'll take it as a compliment because I think South.
What are the other compliments you've got? They've been associating you with North, South, East, West.
Yeah. I look like Maharashtrian, Bengali, Keralite, South Indian, of course. And then when Sardar boys want to hit on me, they say, hey, you look like a Pakka Sardarniya. And I'm
Sardarni.
Like, okay. I
what
don't
about
know
Angelina Jolie?
She's too hot. I can't look like her.
My
resemblance. No, I look like Salma Hayek.
Salma
Hayek. And some people say Penelope Cruz as well.
Oh, coming to this Singh factor, they say that the Supreme Court is almost on the verge of banning Sardarji jokes.
Mm.
You seem to be endowed with a lovely sense of humor as a Singh.
Mm.
So how do you force it? According to me, the Singhs are the most intelligent.
Mm.
Most of them you find in the army. So
right.
I don't know how this dumbness got associated with Singhs. So surprising.
Okay, first of all, a little clarity here. I'm Vishakha Singh Chauhan. I'm a Rajput from UP.
Oh, Rajput, okay.
I'm a descendant of Prithviraj Chauhan, the king.
Wow, warrior. Wow. Warrior, fantastic.
Yeah. No, but so two of
you
my
like
best.
You like fights?
I am good at kickboxing.
Kickboxing?
Yeah, sir, can you please recommend me for one of those boxing films?
No, I just get a kick out of boxing. Nothing. Nothing. You're good in kickboxing.
I am.
You must watch this Vijay film, Badri. That it's centered
okay.
on kickboxing.
Oh, awesome. Okay.
A lovely film. Superb
I will.
Film.
I will.
I'm a huge Vijay fan.
Oh.
Also a Ajith fan.
Okay, good.
Also Rajini fan.
Good.
Also Vishakha fan.
Oh, awesome. Yay, I got my name got taken in the same breath as the three.
And what about your hairstyle?
My hairstyle is this.
So as good as mine?
Yes. I think your hairstyle looks best on you.
Good, good. And what about your dress sense?
Huh, so my dress sense, I wear anything that's comfortable.
Sari, South Indian?
I love saris. I love saris. In fact, I wore a sari at the Cannes Film Festival last year.
Cannes Film Festival?
Yes.
And you were recognized? You had a unique recognition there?
Absolutely. They thought I was some Indian princess, but the photographers knew me. So then they said, oh, Salma Hayek in a sari. I said, no.
Oh, really? Coming to this social networking site, I had a bitter problem. They call it Twitter, but it was bitter for me because I had to give my explanation that this is not the guy, this is not me, because some guy impersonates in my name and keeps bringing out all the commercial aspects of a film and all that, talking ill of people and all that. I made it very clear it is not me. So I think you had a different problem on Twitter, which made you, it's a bitter experience. What was that?
You know, it was a learning experience of sorts, because acting is not considered to be a respectable job. And when you're an actress, they think, oh, you're public property. All right. Now, a normal girl on the road gets lewd remarks and all that. So you can imagine the plight of an actress. Okay. So this, I mean, I get random comments on my Facebook page once in a while. I'm like, all right, fine, ignore, you know.
Okay.
And unfortunately, it's an occupational hazard. I have to keep an official fan page. But there was this person who, he was actually sending me a lot of messages in my inbox in the fan page. So I was like, okay, ignore. Then he started sending me some naked pictures of random people. I started ignoring that. But I think what really ticked me off was the fact that he actually wrote on my, on the page, on below a very simple photograph of mine. And he wrote the comment and he had this picture of a baby or a young child as his profile picture. And that just ticked me off. And my response was actually quite calm. It was quite, I was actually catching a flight to Rome. I was about to board when I saw, and I just replied very calmly to him. But that kind of got blown out of proportion. And it's amazing how Twitter and the social media works, because I was apparently trending for 3 days, even above Tom Cruise, you know, or Brad Pitt, one of those. So I was like, okay. Now, the good thing was I got a lot of support. But the flip side is that out of 99% support, I had 1% people trolling me further and saying the negative. Now, the thing is, the peaceful majority or the sensible people don't make so much of a noise. While they supported, they did it quietly. But the ones that create ruckus did it such a bad way that I almost started feeling bad. I thought I was harassed further by that. And that was really, really, I mean, it really, really spoiled my mood for a long, you know,
really?
For like.
Okay, really.
But then I realized my dad just said a very simple thing to me. And he said, you know, just fight your battles wisely. It really doesn't make a sense.
Glad that you came out of this crisis and very happy. ஒரே ஒரு விஷயம் நல்லா ஞாபகம் வச்சுங்க, விஷாகா சிங் ஜாலியா இருக்கிற வரைக்கும் புத்தியை காமிச்சிங்கன்னா விஷாகா ஸ்டிங் அப்படின்னு. And other areas of interest and more into cricket. What about cricket?
Not much, but I watch when it's an India-Pakistan match.
Is the recent one you watched?
Yes. No, recent one. I was in the I was in an Uber cab going home.
Oh, that's dangerous.
No, Uber cab is pretty safe.
If it is Delhi, it is dangerous, isn't it?
Delhi, I feel you have to be careful no matter what day, night. You just have to be careful.
Everywhere,
in Delhi.
Bus,
yeah.
Car, everywhere.
Delhi is
I admire your guts.
I mean, Delhi. Well. So, but this Uber cab driver was completely listening to the commentary on the radio. Yeah.
And what about the fun that you have on the set or in your business there in Europe? You're Bombay based?
I'm based in Mumbai, Rome and London.
Rome and London. Okay.
Mumbai is my main base.
Okay. Yeah. What about the fun on the set and all that?
Fun on the set, especially when I'm doing Tamil films, I think my co-stars are having more fun because they're constantly pulling my leg and I'm there with my lines like blah, 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 and then they give me all sorts of...
But doesn't that develop a nervousness in you because you're not conversant with the language and...
It is, you know, that is a little bit of a problem because you're always worrying whether you're going to say the line correctly.
Okay.
You know, and especially if you have co-actors, then I start worrying, oh my God, let me not waste their time by repeating. Okay. That's the reason I do my homework. But fortunately, I think something happens when the camera switches on.
What about your sense of intuition and all that? Suddenly you feel I'm going to start falling in love with that guy who's coming there, who's approaching me. So anybody?
Anybody.
Have you developed any intuition like that?
No, I've never had love at first sight. No. No. But I've seen a lot of good-looking people. I feel like, oh, really hot. No,
please.
Then we just click a picture,
me.
I send
please
it to my single girlfriend.
Don't talk about me in my presence, please.
Oh, my God.
Not that. Then, so who are the guys who really fascinated you? I mean, among the celebrities. You said Ajith, that's one.
George Clooney.
He's almost a lookalike.
Well,
that's what we call Ajith.
I just love the salt and pepper look.
Yeah, that's what. Every time we see Ajith, we say he's just like George Clooney and all that.
Well, so now okay, you know my type. Mark Ruffalo, same type.
To name a few of the heroines or the lead actors who are your friends here.
Well, I just have one friend and everybody knows, Priya.
Priya is your dearest.
Yeah, yeah.
So she's a very dear both same type.
Same types. We even look alike. A lot of people say that.
Oh, really?
Know? Yeah.
And what has she got to say about your acting or your version of her performance and all that? Which did you like her most in?
I liked her in my own film, Fukre, the most. And
okay,
I
okay.
actually liked her in Urula Rendaraja. I really, really liked
Urula
her.
Urula
Rendaraja. You know? In fact, I think I'm one of her ardent fans. I keep watching that song of hers, Malakata or something.
Malakata Niyana Sutra.
I think she's super hot in it.
Super hot in it.
Yeah.
So what about glamour? Does it suit you?
No, it doesn't suit me.
I don't want to get into glamour.
I don't. The only closest glamour I've ever done is that Mama song in Kannaladu. The closest I got.
And what about the grammar? Forget the glamour.
My grammar is very good.
No, in acting.
In acting, that my director will have to tell you.
You're getting into some classes of acting, going to some institute, learning something?
Nope.
Never.
I just told you I was born with a limited talent.
How good a devotee are you? Visit temples?
No. I don't.
So don't believe in God.
No, I believe in God, but I don't think I need to.
You're searching for the God.
No, I don't need to go through a middleman to go to God.
Oh.
Simple as that.
No wonder you have your own ashram.
I might.
You might.
Ma Vishakha.
Super. And we had a great time and a great.
No, Bosskey, let's talk more.
Let's talk
I'm
more.
Kidding,
no, then you can ask. You can interview me.
Why the name Bosskey?
That's history because I did my schooling in an Anglo-Indian school. My name is Bhaskar. But the thing is, most of the Anglo-Indians found it very comfortable to call me Bosskey. Hey, Machi, Bosskey, what's your bloody hell?
Oh, that's what
they don't say, what the bloody hell? They say, what's your bloody hell?
Uh-huh.
Where's Johnny? He's standing under the pulley with the nail. That's how they talk.
Is that so? Okay?
Yeah. Machan, horrible buggers. You give an inch, they're bloody taking a mile, man. That's the accent. So they found it very comfortable to call me Bosskey.
Oh, and that's stuck.
Yes, and you said you're not interested in cricket. What about the zodiac? Yeah, let's come to that zodiac. You're a May born, isn't it?
Yes, I'm Taurus the bull.
Taurus.
5th month, 5th day, 5 o'clock in the morning.
What is the speciality? Tell me. 5, it's like omen. 6, 6, 6
yeah,
is
that's
omen.
Triple 6. I'm 555.
You're a good omen, but
I'm a good
again,
omen.
What about this 555? Tell me. How were you treated? What did your parents say? Is something unique about your stars and all that you were born on the 5th month, 5th day? 5 o'clock, is it?
5 o'clock in the morning, yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I don't know. I think my parents just think I'm very special. I think all parents feel their children are special. So
which zodiac you think has got a good compatibility with yours? Taurus.
Okay. So, Taurus is Virgo and Capricorn. Sagittarian best friends, Aquarian best friends.
Only 11 more, totally.
I think I do get along with everybody, actually.
What about Aquarius?
My best friend is an Aquarian.
I'm not your best friend.
Oh, don't break my heart.
So thank you so much. I am almost coming to a close because I've hardly seen a couple of movies of yours.
If I get, I've actually done a couple of films only.
You've done 4, I think. Pudichirugu was first.
Yeah.
Then Kannaladdu Naasaya. Then Uruvurle Rendiraja. And this Valibaraja, how is Valibaraja doing?
Valibaraja.
What is your role in Valibaraja?
Okay, Valibaraja, I'm playing a typical Tamil ponnu, you know, sweet girl. I'm Betty. Betty from
Archie. Caught between one more lover of the hero.
Yes. I'm the best friend. I'm the hero's best friend who helps him fall in woo his girl.
Okay.
And then you see what happens.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And your accent on humor, how much you spend time laughing, fooling around, playing the fool with people?
As I said, in Tamil, not much.
No, in general, in life. Forget
in general, in life, I'm. You know what I'm telling you? If I was not an actor, I would have become a stand-up comedian.
Stand-up comedian?
I would have.
Brilliant, brilliant.
Yeah. But I think I'll just have to lose hair for that, right?
Lose your brain also.
Oh, damn.
So, how naughty or mischievous were you in class? The first or the last bench?
I was. No, I was a very good student.
Brilliant student?
No, not brilliant, but I was good. I was good.
I heard you were the first in class.
No. I used
morning
to come
7:30, you used to go to the class?
I used to come around 7th position in class.
Good.
My
totally 7 students.
24, 42, like that. Oh my God, I'm actually sincerely answering your question. How many students?
Good, good. Sixth or seventh. Good. Yeah. Lovely.
No, but I was a decent student, but and the teachers thought I was one of the best, you know, nice girl. And then I would actually do my naughty stuff and they could never pinpoint that it was me.
We had a great time, Vishakha, and you suited our channel superbly.
Thank
because
you.
With your bubbly presence and all your humor, you really made our day. Thank you so
Thank
much.
You.
Vishakha வந்து அர்ஜென்ட்டாக நான் ஃப்ளைட்டுக்கு போகணும், ஆன் த வே ட்ரான்ஸ்லேட்டில் நான் சாமர்செட்டில் இன்டர்வியூ பண்ணிட்டு போகிறேன்னாங்க. நீங்கள் நம்புங்க, நேஷன் இஸ் கோயிங் டு சிங் த விஷாகா சாங்ஸ், இஸ் கோயின் கெட் ஸோ பாப்புலர். இன்றைக்கி ஃப்ளைட்டில் போகிறாங்க, இட்ஸ் கோயின் டு ஃப்ளை ஹை. தேங்க்யூ ஸோ மச் ஃபார் ஜாயினிங் அஸ்.
தேங்க்ஸ். A big hi to all Bosskey TV viewers, and I'm having a great time today. I just finished an interview with Bosskey, and trust me, it wasn't I won't lie, I had a great time. Well, okay, one of the things I was really, really excited about being on Bosskey TV was the fact that he usually has some amazing people coming on Pen Drive and Heartist. Yes, Heartist. I hope Bosskey calls me again for Pen Drive and Heartist. I actually now I'm going to go back, subscribe to his channel and watch all his videos. I hope you do too.
சாட்டலைட் பிக்சர் ஒருத்தர் கொடுக்குறாரு, ஒருத்தர் ரேடார் கொடுக்குறாரு, ஒருத்தர் கம்ப்யூட்டர் அவுட்புட் தர, எல்லாத்தையும் மிக்ஸ் பண்ணி சில பேர் டிஸ்கஸ் பண்ணிட்டு அது அவுட்புட்டாக நான் கொடுக்குறேன் பப்ளிக் வருது. ஐ ஒன்லி ஃபேஸ்.
10 மைக்கு பார்த்தா உங்களுக்கு டென்ஷன் ஆகுது, எப்படி குஷி ஆகுது,
பழக்கப்படுத்த வேண்டியது.
சப்போஸ் சுற்றி வர 360 டிகிரிஸ் மைக் இருந்தால்
சேர ரொட்டேட்டிங் சேர்ல திருப்ப வேண்டியதா.